Shalom, Chavrim. I'm Stephen Ben-Nun. You're watching Israeli News Live in a world of Ein Shalom. There is no peace, and what we're seeing right now is very disturbing coming out of Syria near Deir ez-Zor there. From what we're understanding right now, and this is from a French paper, Torto.com, JacquesTorto.com is a French paper. We did use the translator to translate the article. I was already seeing reports from our own sources there on the ground in Syria that indeed U.S. warplanes had struck the Syrian military, killing 100 people thus far, including in that our Russian contractors, military contractors there on the ground. This is going to be a major escalation. According to a joint combined joint task force command by the U.S. reporting about this, it was indeed the Syrian government targeting Free Syrian Army forces. They said here, in an unprovoked attack by the Syrian pro-regime forces prompts coalition defensive strikes. Syrian pro-regime forces initiated an unprovoked attack against a well-established Syrian Democratic Forces headquarters February the 7th. Now, I do not know what Syria's response is to this, but then again, it kind of makes you wonder, why is the Free Syrian Army allowed to be able to continue to take land away from the Syrian government and claim it as their own, and then Syria is not allowed to retaliate? It's kind of interesting. And then the U.S. to actually get involved and do an airstrike against the Syrian government forces that not only take out Syrian government forces, but as well kill Russian military forces at the same time. Unless the strike on the Free Syrian Army has actually also taken out American forces, which in that case there would also be a major devastation and not a good thing either for the Syrian government to do. Because if the American forces are embedded with them, that would be a big, big issue and no doubt. And of course, in both cases, on both sides, we don't know the full outcome. We are getting reports on the ground there in Syria that Russian forces were killed along in this. They're calling them contractors because but they are military contractors and advisors to the Syrian army. The question is going to be, though, is whether or not American forces were killed in the Syrian strike against the Free Syrian Army. Now, according to the initial reports that came out on the news, French news here, is that there were no casualties amongst the Free Syrian Army, which kind of makes you wonder then why would there be such an airstrike back against the Syrian government, that also knowing that there are Russian contractors embedded with the Syrian forces there that would create such a massive loss of life. It's a very big issue that's going on right now there. We also know there's a big conflict between the United States and Turkey. Turkey is now talking about going to Idlib to move out more of the Kurdish fighters, but still threatening the U.S. U.S. generals saying they will not move and they will defend themselves if the Turkish military strikes against them. So it could create an alliance between Turkey and Russia that does target the Kurdish people and end up being an all-out war. We do a lot of times on Hebrew Nation Radio Flashpoint with Bonnie Harvey. We talk about where will be the flash that ignites the world. We look like we might be getting a flashpoint right about now. Do pray for all those that are involved. It's a very serious situation. Two world powers involved in this particular conflict here in Syria, and it could easily go in a very bad direction there. So like I say, do let's pray that God will do something that will stop this type of a situation from escalating. And I might mention as well, I also saw this report also on NewsBud, Breaking Insider exposes rogue elements in CIA State Department blocking release of an American pastor from Turkish prison. That's this man right here, pictured on here, and his name is Pastor Andrew Brunson. And that was kind of alarming to me. Of course, we know that President Trump has been trying to get this man's release, but finding out that the State Department has been blocking his release makes me wonder if this pastor doesn't have some inside information that the coup in Turkey was staged from the beginning. Very troubling indeed. I'm Stephen Ben-Nun. You're watching Israeli News Live. Might also share as well, RT has also released this particular news today. True U.S. goal in Syria is to control over the resources, not fighting ISIS, according to the Russian MOD there that's coming out. And that's where the conflict is, on the eastern side of the Euphrates. And of course, that is the most oil-rich part of the Syrian nation. And the U.S. is backing the Kurds now. And they say that the Kurds and ISIS are working together. Local tribesmen are saying that Kurds and ISIS are working together in concert there to take the entire region on the eastern side of the Euphrates. I'm Stephen Benoon with Israeli News Live. Shalom.